This is Lori Stevens. I'm speaking to you from my office on the East Coast in Boston. And just want to say thank you, everyone, for joining us. And thank you to the Calgary Police Department for bringing this opportunity to us to get together today. So what we're going to do today is go through settings on Facebook. And I want to let everyone know that we'll be going to the settings, then we'll be going through graph search. We're going to be looking at just sort of what's the good behavior if you're a police officer, even a civilian, and you're working, you know, just to keep your lives separate and that sort of thing. And this is where we're going to start. I have about, maybe you saw, 5 or 6 slides on Facebook, on the 5 or 6 slides on just to show you. And then we're going to go into Facebook and start with the actual settings and go through every one of them one by one. All right. And so what I do is I have my top, I don't know, 11 or 12 things here that you all should be aware of as law enforcement professionals and how to stay safe and keep your careers protected on Facebook. And so we're going to go through each of these now. And then when we go through the settings, we'll be addressing each and every one of these things. All right. So the first one is turning on secure browsing. And that's a kind of a little one. And a lot of people have found it already, but it has to do with when you're on a public Wi-Fi. So, for example, you're in Starbucks or something like that, and you know, you're just using the Starbucks free Wi-Fi. You don't have secure browsing on. Somebody could come in with the right application. I think it's called FireSheep, and basically get right into what you're doing and be you on Facebook. And so you just want to make sure you have secure browsing turned on. We're also going to look at managing the notifications of tags, things that you're tagged in, and getting notified and being able to look at them before you before you accept them. And to block abusers, those people who just tag you on everything. How do you block them, or how do you just restrict them? There's a couple of different levels of doing that. And then to set those tag reviews on, okay? There's a couple of different ways to review things about you before it's placed onto Facebook, in particular tags. So somebody may put a photo of you on their own page, but tag you in it, and you can see it before that's allowed. Uncheck facial recognition tagging. It's not called that. Facebook doesn't, you know, put a bunch of blinking lights and say, "Here, police officers, look at this. This is this facial recognition thing we're talking about." It's kind of hidden, and it's kind of labeled in such a way that makes it sound like it's something fun, you know, and it's not. And it's a very serious issue, I think, for police officers. Abide by your agency's social media policy. I put that in there because A, I assume you have one, and B, I assume that it has some of the most common language along the lines of not, that you shouldn't be posting photos of any insignia, yourself in uniform, anything that would identify you as a police officer. And a lot of officers, especially the younger folks, tend to think that that's just, you know, an infringement on their First Amendment rights, that they should be able to tell people they're a police officer. And it is, I suppose, could be argued anyway, that you should be able to do that. But what it really is about is officer safety, and not so much about the chief, you know, infringing on your First Amendment rights, but really it's about safety. And then also don't allow others to see pages that you like. I'll show you how to do that here right off the bat. Don't allow others to see who your friends are, and don't allow followers. That used to be called subscribers. That's actually really kind of a small issue. It could be a big issue, just depending on how careful you are with what you share publicly. Review and manage what others share about you. This tends to be an area where I get a lot of wide eyes in my in-person training, because people don't even think to look there. They don't even know that this little setting exists. And it's actually not a little setting. It's about 12 things or so that are checked by default that others share about you if they're friends of yours. So if they're your friends and they're playing those third-party applications and you haven't unchecked these various things, they're sharing all that information about you. It's going right out the door to the creators of that application. And so we're going to show you how to edit that. Review past posts on your timeline and limit the audience of future posts. This is a kind of a nearly impossible thing for me to test. I haven't been able to test it. But what happened is when timeline came into being, and I kind of lost track of the timeline of timeline. I think it was a year ago, maybe 2 years ago. I really am totally off on when it sprouted onto the scene. But it supposedly made more public some past posts that weren't necessarily meant to be public. And so we'll talk about going through those. Beware of graph search. This is huge, huge, huge. And my understanding is Facebook is in the middle of some more changes that's going to make it even a bigger issue. And then the one that is the most important of all, and it's probably the hardest to do, is keep your personal lives separate from your professional lives. And that is on Facebook. And so countless officers have their, you know, their personal pages, but they make it really clear that they're an officer. It's in my opinion, I could be wrong, but it's my opinion, that's just a huge mistake. And sometimes, even if you're careful not to post photos or you know, any other thing, just some comments, you can make some comments that will identify you as an officer. Or one of your buddies is going to post a photo and tag you in it, and in that photo, you or one of them or all of them are in uniform. It's those kinds of things that will immediately identify you as a police officer. And depending on how worried you are about that, it could be a huge issue for you. And so let's talk about the keeping the personal separate from professional. So here I have my brick wall. It's a brick wall in the middle. Hopefully it looks like a brick wall to you folks. And on the left is, you know, professional police officer person. I couldn't find a silhouette of a girl. Sorry, girls. But anyway, that's your professional side of things. And then we have your brick wall. And then on the right side, we have the personal side of you. In your lives, in your personal lives, right? Okay, and let's say you're both on Facebook. I mean, let's say professional use on Facebook, and you're representing your department. You're answering citizen questions or posting things. Not a lot of you do this, but even if you don't, everything we're covering here is very, very, very relevant. But it makes it a little clearer to make these distinctions if we say that you are. And then on the other side is your personal life. And that is just something we say keep completely separate from your professionals. So how do you do that? You know, it's really hard, especially since you folks tend to get together with your buddies from work on off hours, because, you know, I get that it's a very tight circle, and it's just really common that you're friends with the people that you work with. And that's where it's probably the hardest, is how are you going to not friend those people on the personal side of things? Well, I'd say it may be impossible. If it's not impossible, then don't do it. But if you like the people you work with, and I presume you do, and because you're police officers, I know you hang with those guys and girls. And so what we want to do is to the extent that that's happening, make sure that people are being very mindful of the fact that everything they do and everything you do and everything your family does really has a ripple effect on the safety and career survival of anybody who's a police officer who's involved in that chain of events. Because the minute you friend your spouse on your professional side, you put a hole in that wall. And similarly, the minute you friend somebody from work on your personal side, you put a big hole in that wall. So even though I'm saying this and also agreeing that it's pretty darn impossible to keep them separate, I'm suggesting that you think about every action you take and really, is it worth it? Is it worth it to you to mix these two worlds? I'm a huge, huge advocate for police officers being on Facebook as police officers representing their departments. And I believe you should do that because people want to see their real officers on Facebook. You know, most of you folks, if you're on Facebook, if your agencies are on Facebook, you're out there as the agency, and all the posts come from the agency logo. You know, that it's just so impersonal. And that's fine. And there are times when that would be appropriate anyway. But I always advocate for the more you can have a real officer's face show up when you're posting, the better. And when it's the chief, it's even better. And if any of you have seen what's gone on in Brimfield, Ohio, the chief there is posting constantly. And he's the chief when he's posting. It's a tiny town, I think 10,000 people, something like that. Yet they've got 80,000 fans because he uses a lot of humor. And he's a little bit out there, but also because people know who it is, okay? And that's huge. That's just really drives my point home. And so, but anyway, so I'm a huge advocate for that. And I tell police officers on your personal side of life, I don't recommend you're on Facebook. And the reason is not because I don't think you should be on there and having fun and staying in touch with your friends, but because I don't really believe that any of you, or very, very, very few of you, are going to keep up with the settings like we're going to talk about them today. So you're here in this webinar, so that's a good start. But actually, just let's just we got to stay up with it, and it's going to be up to you folks to make sure that your colleagues kind of learn this stuff from you, or they watch this video. So here's a lovely slide. This is actually a police officer, and maybe I should redact his name, but this is from a newspaper, published newspaper article. Okay, so this is not my screenshot from his postings. It's a published newspaper article, and this gentleman is out of, I'll just say, the Texas area. And so he, on his Facebook page, had not indicated, hadn't said he's a police officer, hadn't listed his employer, hadn't, there's no pictures in uniform, except there was one photo of him with a group of friends that I think a couple of them were in uniform. It was the only thing on his Facebook page that could possibly indicate that he was a police officer. And then in a group, it was called Fundy Say the Darndest Things, he is posting this stuff in response to some post. It's, fundamentals. Fundies are fundamentalists, and it's sort of a collection of funny or silly or stupid things that in the opinion of the creator of the page. And so he was in here answering, and he was having this back and forth with somebody. And the long and the short of it is, it really doesn't matter. Anytime you use the word wetback, or the phrase wetback, as he does in the top line there, I mean, I can't imagine a situation where that's appropriate, no matter what, personal life or not. But yeah, he has the First Amendment right to say it. Okay, let's go with that. But what happened was, somebody was so offended by this that he looked into this person. First thing he found was the guy's Facebook page, and saw that photo that had him with some other officers in uniform. And so, bingo, he decides that's proof enough that he's a police officer, and he created quite a ruckus. And in fact, the reason I know about this is because the local reporter called me. And there's an accompanying article that goes with this that quoted me in it. And you know what? It's like, you do ha when I talk to younger officers, and they say, "Well, we have the First Amendment right to say whatever we want." And I say, "Yes, you do. You absolutely do. And you also have the absolute right to be a complete idiot." And I happened to say that to the reporter, and she ended the article with it. It sort of sounds like I'm calling Mr. Fornash an idiot, and I was not. But you know what? If the shoe fits, because it was just an unfortunate choice, I think, on his part. And he, I don't know, I don't think he lost his job or anything like that, but I know that there was an investigation into it. And this is the type of things, this is the type of behavioral thing that he certainly didn't think anybody was ever going to tie it back to Officer Fornash, but the reader did, and the reader did it pretty darn fast. So similarly to how your investigators will create a fake ID to do whatever it is you do when you're looking for pedophiles or gangbangers or what have you, folks are doing that to you, okay? And it always astonishes me that the degree to which officers don't actually necessarily always stop and think about that, okay? So this is just sort of another behavioral thing on Facebook, something to keep in mind as you get friend requests and things like that. Do you actually know the person to be real, to be somebody who you've at least had a phone conversation with? Like, you know that that person really exists. And now this example is about 2 years old. If you recognize the layout of Facebook, it's the older layout, but I still use it because there's a photo of a real police officer on it, and because it was just one that I personally identified at the time, and one that a situation that I was familiar with. And so in this case, you can't really tell for sure. There's never a surefire way to know that somebody is or isn't a real police officer on these, that I know of, on these profiles. But in this case, here he's using a real photo, supposedly, of himself, and yet he says he's sergeant at police. And when you click on police, it's blue there. It's at the top up under his name. You get a Wikipedia type page that just defines police. All right, it's not a police department. So it seems a little odd that he would show his photo and then want to hide his police department. When you go into photos in this particular case, you go into his photo area and you get caricatures and logos and things like that. No real photos of what looks to be real officers. Now, that's a little misleading because I know of a case up in Canada where a pretty well-known police impersonator has hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of photos of RCMP, just gorgeous photos. So he comes across as real. He's actually done jail time and he keeps surfacing, keeps coming on back to various profiles and trying to be friends with police officers. So anyway, the real danger though is guys like this who are trying to friend your officers. And in this case, I had Facebook said to me, you have two friends in common, and those two friends were real police officers, people I've actually met in the flesh. And I emailed them both, and in both cases, they came back to me with, he posts a lot in this group or that group, and he seems like a really nice guy. And I thought, well, sure he does. Of course he does. Just like your investigators try to seem like the real thing when you do, your investigations. And it just, again, it just astounds me that it doesn't occur to these folks that this guy isn't real. And so, in fact, this was unfortunately Officer Larry Niehausel, who was gunned down in Livonia, Michigan, in January of 2011. And when this Facebook page was created, I don't know when it was created. I'm assuming sometime after Mr. Niehausel died, but it was about March when I saw this. So within 2 months, this showed up, and it was only because I knew this photo that I just knew it wasn't right, and that's what caught my attention. But there are hundreds and thousands of these pages out there, and they friend, one officer, then the next officer friends them because the first officer friends them, and then it goes on and on like that. And then pretty soon they try to get into the private groups, and they have no trouble getting in because, the manager of the group sees that he's friends with all these police officers, he must be real. And so that's how they're, that's one of the ways anyway that they're gaining intelligence on you.
So that is it for the slides that I want to show you, but I want to go now into the settings and all of the settings that we need to take care of for your safety.
But before I do that, I want to show you what graph search is. And so graph search came to be about, I would say, 4 to 6 weeks ago. So let's say you want to search and you're a bad guy who wants to hurt police officers. And it used to be if you wanted to find them on Facebook, you had to really work at it. Now with graph search, you can find this the same people and get the same results, but you get them so much more easily. And it's a very effective way to do harm to a police officer, or to find them anyway if you want to. So if I just went in here and I said police officers who live in, let's just pick any big city, let's say Denver, Colorado, see what we come up with. Okay. Police officers who live in Denver, Colorado. Now, again, all of these people here that are popping up are people I could have found, but it would have taken me a long, long time. Now, if you folks put in police officers who live in Denver, Colorado, you're going to get the same results. But you might get them in a little bit different order because Facebook bases it on how you're connected to people. So this guy here might be a second level connection or something like that through Facebook, something along those lines. And so here, police officer at City of Denver. Well, unless Mr. V here is using this page as his professional page and he's out there posting as a police officer for the City of Denver, I would suggest he not say he's a police officer at the City of Denver. And so that, and so then if it is really his professional page and he's saying he's a police officer in Denver, then it wouldn't matter so much, but hopefully he's not going to be giving us any other clues to his personal life. But here he is, he's telling us where he went to high school and everything. So I'm sorry, Danny, we're gonna pick on you just a little bit. Let's just see what we can find out about Danny here. So if we go into his photos, can we see his photos? He either hasn't loaded any or he's hiding them from us. Good, good. We can go in here to profile photos and we can see some profile photos. Doesn't look like any that really look like Danny, I wouldn't guess. So that's good. And so here it says he's got 60 photos. And he's either hiding from us or something, because it says there's 16 there. So that's really great, actually, that we can't see anything. It's at least about his photos, right? And see, look at this. I have one mutual friend with this guy, so that's why he showed up at the very top. Okay, but it would be my preference, if this is his professional profile, that we can't see that he went to Platte Canyon High School. But if it's his personal profile, which I'm guessing, because it usually is, then it shouldn't say that he's a police officer at the City of Denver. But if it's his personal profile, he shouldn't be friending the Buck Savage on it, because that's, some of these other police officers, because that's just a little bit of a giveaway too. But now look at this. It says here he has 435 friends, and I can see his friends. And so this is probably something that I would suggest to Officer Veith, that he hides his friends. I'm gonna show you how to do that in just a second. And so again, if it's his personal profile, definitely hide your friends. Nobody should be able to see your friends unless they're connected to you. Now I am connected to him. Remember, we have one mutual friend. So maybe I'm seeing it because of that reason, and I'm showing it to all of you guys because I'm connected to him, and otherwise you wouldn't be able to see it. I don't really know that. But I suspect that that's not the case. But we will try not to pick on Mr. Veith any longer. But let's just, for the other thing I want to show you, is just kind of go through here and see. So this is going to be police officers who live in Denver, Colorado, not necessarily who work for Denver Police. So there's others here that identify themselves as an officer, but maybe work for other employers other than Denver. So similarly, if I went in and said police officers who work for Denver Police, it's going to give me a different result, and presumably Danny might be at the very top of that one as well. So, all right. So, the only thing you can do for graph search, and I really, really, really recommend it, is again, in your personal profiles, if you put anything that says you're a police officer, it's going to come up this easily. And in your personal profiles, where you're friending your kids and you're friending your spouses and your other family members, I just strongly, strongly recommend not saying you're a police officer. Again, it's not because the chief says so, even though the chief thinks it's because he or she says so. It's really because it's for your safety. And then, make sure your spouses and your kids, and just like you caution the kids not to be talking about being your mom or dad being a police officer, to their friends at school, in real life, they need to be careful about that online too, and not be giving any indication about that sort of thing. And so that's graph search. And what you want to do is just go in and play with that, and just use that example that I gave you and put in your city and see what happens. And I suspect you'll come up with some people, people you don't know, but people who live and work near you. All right, and then let's go back to our homepage here. And a couple things I want to point out here is that this avatar photo and this cover photo right here are two things that you cannot hide on Facebook, no matter what you do. And so why should you care about that? Well, obviously, your avatar photo, if it's your face, is going to be something that plays right into facial recognition. If somebody then does make that connection that you're a police officer, they really want to find you. They could pop you in and to those programs. But right here in Facebook, it'll connect you as well. But also, I've seen it time and time again, and I have a police chief friend in Michigan who puts his photo right here in uniform, saying he's the chief of police. And then right here in his cover photo, he's got him and his two little cute little boys. There he is as the dad, and here he is over here as the chief. And that's just the ultimate example of what not to do if you want to be safe on Facebook, and keep your kids safe on Facebook. Anyway, so you can't hide these two things, and don't forget that. And so a lot of officers will put, insignia here if it's their personal profile. Well, we don't want that, right? Because we don't want you saying you're a police officer. So I've seen, your canoe. Put your canoe in here. Put anything in there but your own photo. Unless you really are out there. It's a really small town. These are really risks for you to take. But the main thing to know is that you can't hide this. There was a case in Phoenix where a whole bunch of officers were outed, and a disc was made, and it was distributed. These are police officers, It was just their faces, but when they lost an officer, they had all of those folks had changed their avatar to the thin blue line, and so when they changed it back, whoever made the disc culled all those photographs and saved them and kept them and created the disc to identify police officers. So just keep that in mind. And your cover photo. All right. So before we move into the settings, a couple more things I want to show you right here on this page is here's photos. Okay. So if you go into my photos, you see a few photos in here. If I wanted to hide these photos, okay, now these happen to be professional photos, and I use this page as my marketing. So I keep this page pretty public, okay? These are all shots from the Smile Conference or something like that that I've done, okay? There's Officer Squeezy. He's an important guy to the Smile Conference. So I don't really care about hiding mine, but if I wanted to, I would go into my photos just like I showed you. I'd go up here to edit, and I click on edit, and then I just come in here and edit the, you're going to have something different shown here. And you can just edit your privacy on these photos. The other way to get at all of this stuff is right over here. Oh, and in friends, the same way, okay? Go into your friends, click on your edit button, and hide the privacy of your friends list. Yeah, let's see if we can get this to work. Edit privacy. Now, you can see mine now because I'm in here as me, right? But you can see here that I say, who can see your friends list? And I say only me. And in this case, it's not really my safety that I'm trying to protect. It's more the people I'm friends with, because again, this is the, you know, police officer friends. This is my professional page. So everyone that's on here is pretty much going to be connected to policing in some way. All right. So, but also here under the more section, especially go down to things like your likes. Okay, you go into likes, and so here's the suggested likes at the top here. When we go down farther, these are going to be the things that I've really hit the like button on. And again, in my case, I don't think anybody's going to hold anything against me. I mean, maybe I'm a Clemson fan. Maybe they don't like that, or Cornhuskers, but it's nothing that could be used, you know, like that, like the defense attorney will use against you if you like a page that could they could possibly use and construe in a way to cause you to lose your case. So you want to hide your likes. And again, you just go right up here to edit right here over in this side over here and say edit the privacy. All right. And then set these locked to only me for every single one of them. All right. So I have mine and only me. It's not a big deal if I open mine up because I don't really like anything too questionable in here except for police pages. So I guess some people might think that's questionable. But for the most part, it's different in this case. But for you, especially if you're liking anything that somebody can construe in any way, but even if you're not, you know, really what business is it? And again, we're talking about your personal profile. All right. If it's your professional profile, I would actually like hit the like button on all your restaurants and all your businesses that support you and fellow, you know, police agencies or what have you, police officers who are actually on Facebook as police officers and let people see it. But, you know, that's, again, it's just how comfortable do you feel with all of that? But, and so each of these areas, you're going to go in and hide the various things and do note that under more, there's more. Okay. There's lots of things. TV shows would be a good thing. Books, you know, just hide those things so that people don't see them on your personal page, especially in the event that they then identify you as a police officer, no matter how careful you think you're being. Okay. All right. I'll be referring to activity log as we go through the settings. I just want, in case I forget to point it out there, that you can get to your activity log here. And you can see that it's telling me that I have 8 activities to look at. And this is the stuff that I have for review and things like that. But we'll look at them when I'm on the inside. All right. So let's go into the settings. And what I want to do is I'm going to move a little bit faster to try to make up just a couple minutes. But I want to go into, I want to click this gear up here. See the gear up in the very upper right-hand corner? And I want to go down to settings and either account settings or privacy settings. It's very, very, very similar what you get when you come in here. If you go into privacy settings, you get this page and by default, it starts at privacy. If you go into account settings, you get the same page. It just starts up here at general settings. All right. So click either one of those and then go down to We're going to start at the bottom and we're going to go up and we're going to start with apps. Okay, so here we are on the apps page, and this is going to be the apps that you have installed on your Facebook page. So if you did happen to click one of those third-party games, you know, Mafia Wars or, you know, if I were a Simpson character, which one would I be kind of things, it's going to be in here. And you can just come in here and you can scroll through. See, it says show all apps 64. You can get to every single one of them and go in there and just see. And you should every now and then. I know it's hard to believe that I have 64 that are legit, but I really do. And but if there's any squirrely ones in there, you can just take them right out right here. But the really important area here, not that that's not important, is below all that. Okay, so we're not covering this this here, older versions of Facebook for mobile. That I don't have any identifiable officer safety issue in there. But we want to look at instant personalization, and we want to look at apps others use. Okay, so instant personalization, you see that I have mine set to auth. This is Facebook's way of what they call enhancing your Facebook experience. All right, so let's just click on this really quickly and go in here, and no matter what it gives you this video, just close it. All right. So now we're in here on instant personalization. Let's see what's in here. So it says here they've partnered with a few websites to provide you with great personalized experience the moment you arrive. All right. Such as immediately playing the music you like or displaying friends' reviews. Isn't that nice? And so it is kind of nice, I suppose, if you've got no cares in the world and you really you aren't worried about things. But we all know that that's not the case for the people on this call. And so if you have this enabled, all of those companies there in blue in the middle here is getting your information. They're all getting your information. And maybe that's okay with you. You can one by one disable them somewhere else. But until and unless you do that, I would highly recommend you not click enable instant personalization with these sites, okay? And I would take it very seriously that you need to learn what each and every one of these do and trust them. This one right here is very interesting. Bing, as you all know, is a search engine like Google. If you think you're hiding yourself from being found on Facebook in Google and Bing, there's a setting in here which I'll show you that is to take yourself out of public search. You can do that. But with instant personalization, because it includes Bing, means that, well, if I use Bing outside of Facebook, I might not find you, but I can log into Facebook and search your name or whatever, your phone number, whatever, and find you, right? This is a little gotcha, and it's especially important for police, I think, because if you think you're taking yourself out of public search, we're talking about your personal profiles here, and then you don't disable this, I can find you just as easily with Bing inside of Facebook. And when you consider there's 1. Whatever billion people on Facebook right now, pretty much everybody can get into Bing and find what they want to find. All right. So we're going to close that. And so again, just disable that unless you really want to go in and play and enable it for certain of those features. I've just disable it. This is the big one here. This is the one about what others share about you. Okay. So click on that. And when you open this, by default, I believe, unless they've changed it, all of these things are checked. So this is that area where with third-party games that people play, what info of yours are they sharing? So even if you're very careful not to play those games, but even if, I mean, some of you aren't, you know, but let's say you are. We've all got a friend or two that does it, right? And some of them are cops because that's where I get the invites, right? And so if you don't have these things unchecked, when they play those games, they're giving up their info, but they're also giving up yours. Okay. And, you know, unless you really study this stuff, you don't get that. Right. So I have mine selected that, you know, if I'm online, I don't have any religious or political views on my page anyway, but I uncheck all of this. And so I would strongly recommend that you're careful about what religious and political and some of this other stuff you put in anyway. I don't know why you would do that, except, you know, you really want to make it easy for the high school buddies to find you. I suppose you'll have to tell them where you grew up. But I would be very, very, very careful about what you put in there, what you leave checked, regardless of what kind of profile this is. If it's your professional profile, I would strongly recommend you not put any personal stuff in there anyway. Okay. So, but you might want to put your status updates in. You think about your professional profile, you're posting for your PD. Yeah, put your status updates. Put your, if you're online, if you want to take messages when you're at work, if that's appropriate for what you're doing and what have you. But otherwise, just leave all these things unchecked. Okay. And so we're going to close that. And we're going to go to another area. So that's everything under apps. Okay. So apps you use, apps other use, and then the instant personalization based upon what apps you're going to give access to your site. All right. So I'm going to go up here to followers. So here we are. We started with apps. We're going to go up and we're going to click on followers now. Now followers, this is what I mentioned, used to be called subscribers. All right. So people could subscribe to you. And what this means is that, let's say I send somebody a friend request. Let's say any one of you on this call, I send you a friend request and you don't want to be my friend and I don't blame you. But what Facebook is going to do is send me a message that says, or just right there in the dialogue, and you've probably seen it. It says, you know, so-and-so, she will get your friend request the next time they log in. In the meantime, you are subscribed to all of their public posts. Okay. And so you don't even have to accept my friend request and I can still see your public post. Well, I can see your public post anyway, if I go to your page, right? If I'm really stalking you and I'm not seeing your person, you know, your friends of friends or your friends only posts. However, my experience is that most of you aren't too careful about what audience you give to each post. And so why make it even easier for somebody to see your posts. So of the 12 or so things I listed in the beginning, this is the one I said, it's kind of a small thing, but it really depends on how careful you are. All right. So unless you're going to be really careful, I would uncheck this. I have mine checked because again, this is my marketing page, right? I usually have it checked because it's my marketing page. I don't really care who subscribes to me. Okay. And so I think it's on or off depending on what kind of, when I'm doing this training, but I usually leave it on. I don't care. So, but in your case, I recommend just not checking that box. So mobile isn't really anything to do with officer safety. It's how you're going to set up your phone so you can post to it from your phone and so forth and so on. Not any officer safety issues except for later when and if you allow people to find you by your phone number, especially if you're using a personal phone number. So notifications, I'm going to go through this a little bit quickly to leave enough time for some of the other areas. But basically what you have is how do you get notifications on the top half of the page and then what notifications are you going to get? Okay. And so, for example, the big one is tags. Okay. If I click on edit for tags, what notifications I get, I want to get notifications when I'm tagged by anyone. Okay. Again, it's not an officer safety issue. I just want to be on top of things. I would strongly suggest that you have yours set to anyone on any page, really, on your personal page, because you want to make sure that people aren't getting you into trouble or causing any issues, and on your professional page because you want to stay on top of any, you know, your activity if you're kind of in that social media world. So anyway, I have mine set at anyone, right? So I want to get notifications. So how do I get these notifications? Okay, so I don't get any via text on this particular account. You know, it just sort of depends on how I use or how you want to use Facebook, right? I have two Twitter accounts, for example. I have one that I don't have to stay on top of so closely. I have some notifications come in via email, but the one I really stay on top of, which is LawsCom, I have that come in via text. So anytime anybody sends me any kind of anything with LawsCom, I get it via text. Just how kind of, you know, how on top of this you want to be. All right. So do you want them by email? Do you want them just on Facebook? Okay. And so for the most part, I've got things coming in via Facebook, but I can get them via email. All right. I don't even know what I have this set for anymore, but only notifications about my account security and privacy. Okay. So I could probably put all notifications. I think that's what I normally have, but I'm actually okay with getting my notifications all on Facebook. I'm pretty sure if we go up here and we look, it's going to be everyone. All right. So I get notifications on Facebook for everything. So what notifications do you want to get and how do you want to get them? I think the main lesson here is that you really want to get notifications I would think, for activity that involves you and tags at least. Okay, so this is, you know, the rest of this is just sort of kind of keeping the house clean sort of stuff. All right, but the stuff that's important for you as tags and activity that involves you. Blocking. Let's go up to blocking. I'm clicking on blocking over here on the left. This is a really interesting and useful area. Okay, there's all kinds of stuff in here that would be really useful to you. This top one, let's just go start at the top and go right on down. This restricted list is an area, I call it the boss button, because this is something you can use for restricting people from getting information about you, even if they're your, like, if they're your friend, all right? So the example I use of this is an agency that I was working for, and the deputy chief was really gung-ho about this stuff, and he was so excited, and he was on Facebook as soon as he opened his account, and he was friending everybody in the PD, and he was just sending friend requests, and for one thing, he was just excited, and he thought Facebook was going to be really cool for him at work, and it was a professional page and everything, but not all the boys and girls wanted to be friends with the chief, and so I started to hear from some of them, you know, what do I do? The chief wants to be my friend on Facebook, and it just didn't even occur to the chief that, you know, the deputy chief in this case, that folks aren't going to want to be his friend. And so in this case, in that particular case, I was able to just go back to the chief and say, you know, maybe you don't want to do that. And then he sort of got that. But, you know, I think what you could do is go ahead and let the chief be your friend. You know, if you're really worried about it affecting your career, friend the chief. And then you can go into this list right here. And look, it says here, they can only see information and posts you make public. So this is your friends. You add your friends to your restricted list. They can only see what's public anyway. And the best thing about it is they don't get a notice. The chief doesn't get a notice that says officer so-and-so put you on the restricted list. That would be like a death sentence, right? But they don't. I promise you, they get nothing that says that. So it's just, you know, if they're paying that close attention, the most they will notice is, gosh, you don't seem very active on Facebook. But that's it. So they would only be able to see what you post publicly, all right? And they don't know, all right? So, okay, this one, however, is block users. So this is like you just like, you want them gone. You want them, you know, out of your life for whatever reason. Either they're just posting too much stuff or what have you. They're sending you too many, you know, game requests or they're just bugging you a lot. They're harassing you. Now you can see I have two blocked users. And at this point, I can't even tell you who these people are. Well, I sort of remember the top one. He was just annoying me. So I blocked him. This was years ago. And that's all I remember. But I leave him in here. I could unblock him. I'm sure they've long forgotten who I am. But I just leave him in here just because I have him in there and I do this training. So I apologize if any of them are a friend of yours. But those are just people I blocked for whatever reason. And that's how they show up here. So you can see that you can come in here. You can just unblock them if you want to. But you can block users by putting in their email, and you have to have the email they use on Facebook, or their name. But you know, if they're connected to you, Facebook will find it. All right, and you just click block them, and then they won't get anything from you, and they can't send you a request or anything. And then this is going to be block app invites, but this is going to be from certain people. So maybe you've got somebody who's bugging you and you don't really want to block them entirely like you would up here, but just down here you can block invites from a certain person or persons. All right, so there's always that person sending you way too many invites. You can go ahead and put their name in there, okay, and that'll just block the invites requests from them. And then event requests, the thing about events, the way Facebook sets them up is a lot of people, when they first start using them, they don't understand how to restrict the recipient location and all that. And so if they start sending out a whole bunch of events in the beginning until they learn how to do that, the same people might be getting lots and lots and lots of events. So, you know, if this happens to you, try to be a little bit tolerant of the poor folks who are trying to use Facebook, learn how to use Facebook. But if you do just get lots and lots of event invites from somebody or, you know, group, like a business, is probably a little more likely. You can block the event invites without blocking them, just by putting their name in this area. All right. And then You can block apps entirely on the bottom here, okay? Just the app, so it can never do anything to your account. And I even forget what Viddy is, but Bing is in here because of what I showed you earlier on public search. I had found out that little gotcha with Bing being able to find you inside of Facebook years ago, actually. It was a completely different interface. I hadn't seen anything written about it, but I just sort of found it in there and did some testing, and sure enough, kind of discovered it that way. And so I blocked Bing in a completely different interface, and it's showing up here. And I just leave it just again so I have it in there, because again, I kind of want people to find me, but I leave it in there for just to be able to do this training and have something in there. But anyway, you can do it there. So if you want to go through and leave all of those instant personalization things, leave that enabled, and then come in here and selectively block some of them, you can do that too. All right. Timeline and tagging. Who can post on your timeline? Oh, and by the way, I do expect to have time for questions. And if we go a little past the hour, I'll stay. I mean, the rest of you can dump out if you want to. But if anybody has questions, go ahead and put them in the question section in the interface, and I will answer them to the best of my ability before we call this a webinar here at the end of it. All right, so who can add things to my timeline? Who can post on your timeline, and then reviewing posts, friends tag you in before they appear on your timeline. So let's take a look at that. Who can add things to my timeline, and in my case, I have it set at friends. It's not a lot of selections in there. If you say only me, it sort of kind of defeats the purpose of Facebook. But you should know this is in here in case, you know, you've got somebody you're worried about and you don't have time to keep an eye on them. You just go in for, you know, a short time, put this at only me. Or if you're going on vacation or something and, you know, you just don't want to have to worry about it, you can come in here and put only me. The other thing you can do if you go on vacation is deactivate your page for a short time, and I'll show you how to do that as well. Alrighty, so review posts friends tag you in before they appear on your timeline. Okay, so this is one of our top few things on that first slide. Turn review on. All right, so here mine is on, and if I go into edit, you can see this is how I did it. It says enabled. All right, so I just have it enabled. So if I'm going to be, people are going to be posting, tagging me in posts on my timeline, I'll be able to review it, theoretically anyway, before it appears on my timeline. I swear I've seen things on my timeline that I haven't approved, but in any case, that's where it happens. Who can see things on my timeline? Okay, so let's start at the bottom here because this top one's kind of interesting. Who can see what others post on your timeline? Okay, so somebody else posts things on my timeline, who's going to be able to see it? All right, so that's pretty wide open. So if I have things on my timeline and somebody comes in here and just adds to it, whatever, friends can post it, but who can see it, right? So, you know, reason I wouldn't have mine set to friends of friends, it's not that big a deal, but I would probably recommend for you folks to leave it at least as locked down as friends, all right? So again, who can see what others post in your timeline? So here's, you got to think to those fun folks you work with who may not be as careful as you'd like them to be, and they start posting things on your timeline. Like, you know not to post a photo of yourself in uniform, but, you know, maybe they don't. Or you know not to post photos of yourselves having a really good time on the weekend, but they think it's just funny as heck to post that on your timeline on your behalf. So you could, if you've got those kinds of friends, and I'm sure you do, you could just, you know, you can nail it down a little more if you want to. All right. So that's not a horrible thing to do. And just really want to give that some thought. It's just sort of how comfortable are you? And I hate to say it, but it seems like and this is really going to be probably wrong to say, but where it comes to seems to be a bigger problem, I should say, the younger you are. Nothing against young folks, but it just seems like younger officers have bigger issues with other people posting things about them. All right, so let's move up here. Who can see posts you've been tagged in on your timeline? Okay, so this is what others post on your timeline, and then this is going to be things that you've been tagged in. All right, so somebody tags something, puts on your timeline, you reviewed it, you said, okay, that's good to go. Who can see it now? All right. So if you've approved it, I suppose, why wouldn't it be at least okay for friends to see it? If you're approving, if you're reviewing all your tags, it seems like to me it would be fine to let, people see it, friends or even friends of friends, depending on what it is. And then this is interesting. You review what others see on your timeline. Okay. So you can check to see what the boss can see. You can check to see what anybody can see on your timeline. If you get all your settings set and you kind of want to know if you've got them correct, you can come in here and put somebody's name in there just to kind of see, what they can see. So by default, it's going to give it this tool lets you see what others other what your time looks to the public or a specific friend. Okay, so I believe this is going to be yeah to the public. All right. So if somebody came to my timeline and okay, now this is my timeline not as me, right? So and I have it locked down. I don't want it locked down. It's locked down because I do this training, but it's fine. So if somebody doesn't know me, comes in here and sees this is all they're going to see. And it's all right. I don't put too much on personal stuff. I don't put any personal stuff on this profile anyway. I don't put any personal stuff on my personal profile for that matter. But I can come up here and I can say view as a specific person, and I can put the boss's name in there. Or I could tell you it's really great not having a boss, guys, but I guess most of you do. And so you can put the boss's name in there, or you can put who's ever name in there that you want to, and you can see your timeline the way the way they will see your timeline. So let's just check something. Well, I've got that as public. It seems like I had one of these locked down. Look at, see likes. Likes was in there before. My likes aren't even showing up now. So nobody can go in there and see them, right? So that's what it looks like if you edit your likes to nobody can see them. All right, so I'm gonna go back now. How can I manage tags people add and tagging suggestions? Okay, so this is tags people add. So review tags people add to your own post. So you post something and somebody comes in behind you and adds tags. All right. Again, review is on. Okay. So there's a couple different areas to have review on, but it's enabled. All right. So up here, review posts friends tag you in before they appear on your timeline. So in other words, that's how they're putting it on your timeline. They're posting something about, the football game this weekend, and they put your name in it. That places it on your timeline. That's tagging, timeline tagging. It puts it to your timeline. Okay? All right. So now we're talking about review tags people add to your own posts. So you post something. Can they add tags to it? And then do you get to review them ahead of time? Well, of course you would want to do that. When you're tagged in a post, who do you want to add to the audience if they aren't already in it? Okay, this is one I sort of even have a hard time understanding myself. So you're tagged in a post, and how whatever the default is, who do you want to add to it? Why would you add anybody to it? It's bad enough whoever's by default going to see it sees it. Don't add anybody to it. I don't get that one. Why you would want to add anybody to it if they're not already in there? And then who sees tag suggestions when photos that look like you are uploaded? Now, do any of you think this sounds like facial recognition? Because that's what this is, okay? And Facebook doesn't tell you facial recognition, this is what this is. It just kind of puts this out there like it's really nothing. And it's not nothing, all right? So if somebody posts a photo and they don't even know you, but they just post a photo and maybe they know the other person in it or not, Facebook may say, hey, this looks like so and so. Would you like to tag him? And that's going to happen unless you come in here and turn it off for yourself. Okay. So if I put, Albert up here, Facebook may say to me, hey, this looks like Albert. Do you want to tag him? That sort of thing. I mean, based upon this photo that they have, and I put one of the other photos on, it's going to refer back to that and know that that's this guy, Albert Hong, and say, hey, do you want to tag him? So please, please, please put that at no one. And this is one of the big reasons that you probably shouldn't be on Facebook if you're a cop, but you are. I know you are. So at least turn this off. Facial recognition is only getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and there's going to be absolutely no hiding from it anyway. All right, we're past time, so I got to get through these things. Who can see my stuff? Your future posts. Okay, so any posts by default. What's the default setting for your future posts? Okay, this is kind of ties partly into what I mean by how careful are you when you put posts out there. So by default, what are your posts going to be? Okay, so they could be by default public or by default anything you want. All right, I tend to have mine at public. It's set at friends right now. I would say public is fine for you folks if you remember every time you post something to define the audience as smaller. And this is probably where you don't really, okay? So when we're talking about people being able to follow you or subscribe to you and that sort of thing, if you have it set at public by default, you're probably not going to be careful enough to change that if you don't really want it to be public. So what I would suggest for you folks is to say friends or custom if you have a custom list. But until then, say friends. Okay, so your default posting, if you don't do anything when you post something, the only people that are going to see it are your friends, all right? But then with every single post, you can change it, right? Right on the screen when you post something, you can change, okay? See, so it says here, this is the same setting you find right where you post. And by changing it here, you've also updated it there, okay? But this is where it'll be by default. So I recommend at least lock down as much as friends. Review all posts and things you're tagged in. Use activity log. This is the thing I said you can find on your homepage as well. So these are the kinds of things. So I said I liked a link. It's very funny. It's a very funny thing. Anyway, go click on that. It's pretty cute. And just, you know, a message that I said to somebody, whatever. This isn't on my thing yet. So I'm going to say aloud on timeline just in case you guys want to come in and check that out because it's very, very funny. All right. Who can contact me? Nope. Wait, I'm too far ahead here. Review all posts and things you're tagged in. Use activity log. That's what we just said. Limit the audience for posts you've shared with friends of friends or public. So this is that issue I told you about with timeline. When timeline first came out, it made some posts from the past that weren't public become public. So, and it's not anything you can really test. It's supposed to give you this warm, fuzzy feeling by clicking it that you can say limit old posts, that if you said it should be friends or friends of friends, it switched back to that. I don't know, just do it, okay? But then I would suggest you also go through your timeline because any post from 2-3 years ago that, you know, may have been questionable whether or not you should have posted it, but there wasn't an issue, might be an issue, and it be more likely people would see it because of timeline. All right. Who can send you friend requests? I have mine set at everyone. You can certainly very easily set that to just friends of friends if you want it to be. Whose messages do you want filtered into your inbox? All right. I just have mine set at whatever the default is, but you can set it so that only people you're friends with go into your box, and then people you're not really acquainted with don't. They go into a separate folder. You still get their messages if you have your messages. You know, if you have your page sets, you can get messages. So, anyway, if you really want to nail it down, you can make it more strict. But you're still going to get all the messages that you want. You know, that people send you. Who can look you up using your email address, your phone number? I have mine set at everyone. You might want to nail that down so that people can't. They get a hold of your phone number or your email address, especially on your personal side. On your professional side, I don't see why you would do that. I would leave it open, but that's, you know, that's up to you. And then do you want other search engines to link to your timeline? This is public search, okay? We talked about this a little bit. Bing, Google, outside, they're not logged into Facebook. Somebody pops in your name, your phone number, what have you. Your Facebook timeline comes up, right? If you leave this off, I have mine on, but if you disable this, theoretically anyway, Google does not archive your Facebook timeline. Bing does not archive your Facebook timeline. But again, with that instant personalization, Bing still will, unless you also disable that there. All right. I know this is a lot to go through. So very quickly, security. This is the turn secure browsing on. And so as long as this is on, you have this, see up here, HTTPS. Up here in the upper left in the URL, that's secure browsing. And so that's going to be, if you do use some public Wi-Fi, this is a layer of protection. It's a very small layer, low-level layer of protection. And so the only real safe way is to always have your own air card if you're in public places using Wi-Fi, but at least have that turned on, okay? Login notifications. and login approvals and recognized devices and all of these sorts of things. Some of them kind of tie into each other. Let's start at the bottom one here, active sessions. I'm logged in currently from Newburyport, Massachusetts. I'm sitting in my home office, and it's the only place I'm logged in from. This is one of the first times I've come in here and I didn't have four or five active sessions. As long as every other active session that's listed in here is one that was actually you, and as long as it isn't a public place like, you know, the hotel business center, it's not that big a deal. But if you see them and you see ones like the hotel business center that you just stayed at, you want to deactivate that. Because theoretically, you're leaving open some access to your account. Not so much that people could actually get into it. I believe what it is, they can just get information off of that platform. I'm not exactly certain. But just make sure that any current sessions are actually you. And if they're not ones you need anymore, just close them. Recognize devices. If you can set it so that every time you come in here with any device, you can give it a name. And so these are various devices or various names I've given various places I log in from. And so whenever I log in from them again, it just lets me right in. But if it's not recognized, it'll ask me for a name. And then up here, login notifications, I'll get an email that says, you logged into your Facebook account from this computer named whatever. And then at least I know if it wasn't really me, I know somebody got into my account, right? It's never happened to me, but it doesn't mean it won't, and doesn't mean it sure wouldn't happen to you. So you just want to make sure that these devices here are ones that you use, okay? And then remove them if you don't, or you don't anymore, right? You were someplace and you did have to give it a name, but you want to take it out now. You just remove it right here. Trusted contacts is an area where you can, if you lose your password or lose access to your account, you can set up trusted contacts that will help you get into it a little bit faster than you'll get into it if you rely on Facebook to work with you, because it might take you a few days to get it from Facebook. So you can have some trusted contacts. App passwords doesn't have any real bearing on officer safety, at least not directly. So login approvals, you can set an extra layer here to keep other people from logging in by setting up a code, okay? And then that ties this part into it. You can set up a code to log into your Facebook account every single time if you want to. Maybe you have a reason to do that. That's up to you. And so here we are up under general settings. There's no real officer safety issues up here. The only thing I want to say is that to be sure to set, that you've set a username. So click on this area and set your username so this part of your URL is customized to you. I still see a few police agencies that haven't done that, and they at least Facebook now gives you one, but it's still usually something that's not all that memorable, if you know what I mean. So with that, I just want to say thank you so much and reiterate that I do these training sessions in two-day formats. Anybody can host one. You get free tuition. So let me know about that. I'm opening up the questions. So if you've got some questions, go ahead and put them in here. If you think of something after we end this session, I'm pretty easy to find. You can tweet me or email me or what have you. I'm Lauri, L-A-U-R-I, at lawscom.net. Lawscom with two M's on Twitter, 24/7. My cell number is 978-764-9887. I'm at your service anytime you guys need anything at all.